Hi everyone and welcome to Sugar Spice Nice. My name is Shweta and in this video I'm going to be taking you through my Sunday brunch experience at the Hilton Mumbai. Let's just take a look at how pretty this place is. I understand it's a 5-star, but there's some level of an extra royal feeling at the Hilton. And the view while having lunch is this beautiful, lush greenery, and you can also see the pool. Now that we've seen the place, I think it's time to start indulging in their appetizers. They've actually brought about two of them to my table here already. I have the grilled cottage cheese and I also have the vegetarian shami kebabs. Even drinks are a part of this menu, so I've ordered myself a fresh coconut water and I also have the fresh orange juice here on my table. So let's start. The paneer actually has a drizzle of this mango kind of puree, and it's honestly the only flavor that's coming from the paneer. So it's nice if you like cottage cheese plain, and this is the little subtle flavor with it. I absolutely love the kebabs. Their texture is just the right kind of crunchy, and inside the filling is extremely flavorful. Even the chutney that they've served with it, it's delicious. Next we have these vegetable cutlets, and wow, there's a lot of peas in there, and this is actually their salsa sauce. You can actually taste so many vegetables from that cutlet. There's corn, there's peas, there's cauliflower, there's a bit of potato. It is a little bit on the spicier side, but I love it. I didn't really try the salsa, so I'm going to try that now. Tangy goodness. They'll actually help to tone down the cutlet a bit. So now that we're done with the appetizers, let's just go tour the whole brunch. A lot of you tell me that I don't show the non-vegetarian items. So here I'm just giving you a sneak peek. This is the gosht pulao, peking chicken, fish in spring sauce, Moroccan lamb stew, roasted chicken, keema matar, murgh rogani, and of course there'll be soup, and they have the chicken manchow soup. Let's get to the vegetarian section. So here I have the onion and thyme soup. This is dam ka kaddu. This is paneer khurjan, moong methi sabzi, anardana wale aloo. Here we have a paneer kesari pulao, dal tadka, plain steamed rice. Also have some pickles. Then we have the kumbh butta masala, lehsuni palak, roasted baby potatoes, spinach and cheese cannelloni. This is the au tin. This is the masaman curry. We have haka noodles and stir-fried vegetables. So you even have a little bit of Asians. Here you'll see a board which states the starters for the day. So there are non-veg and there are vegetarian starters. And vegetarian, you already saw whatever I had. They also have a really wide variety of salads. This is the fish, mushroom and corn salad. There's a Hawaiian salad. This is a lamb and potato salad, chicken, zucchini and aubergine salad, tomato mozzarella salad. There's a marinated grilled veggies salad. There's also an aloo papadi chaat, there's Greek salad and there's pasta salad. You have cut vegetables like cucumber, tomatoes, onion, carrot, lettuce. The salads do come with their dressings and vinaigrettes, so you can choose from this massive variety. Along with that, you'll also find things like curd rice, and I think this is a bundi raita. And there's also a choice of plain yogurt and flavored yogurt. Trying the onion and thyme soup now. I like the flavor of onion, so I like it. And thyme as a herb has a very lingering flavor, so It's actually quite nice. This is a strawberry flavored yogurt and it's in this kullad, which is cute. Next, let's try the pasta salad. It's got a bit of carrot, a little bit of herbs, not too much of chili flakes. It's actually quite good. Next, I'm gonna try the vegetable au gratin. The spinach and cheese cannelloni is amazing. It is not at all feeling chewy and the filling is just so good. It's time to try some noodles. The gravy that I got with the noodles is really mild. It's good for people like me who like non-spicy food. But if you like it spicy, you might want to ask for a few sauces. So far, I've loved the fact that they have so much of choice in vegetarian food. Normally, brunches are a lot more friendly towards the non-vegetarian side. So you'll find a ton of live counters for non-vegetarian items, be it cold cuts, be it sushi, be it other counters. But here, I'm liking the fact that there are lesser live counters. But the food is really nicely spread and they've not really forgotten the vegetarian folks. Now I'm gonna go get myself some more Indian main course. Literally got everything that I hadn't tried. And here we have the roasted baby potatoes. Then this is the aloo anardana sabzi. Then this is the lesuni palak. This is the kesari paneer pulao. And this was a mushroom and corn sabzi, but I only tried to get the corn. And this was a methi and moong sabzi. This is paneer khurchan. This is the kaddu sabzi. This is the dal tadka. And of course, it is never complete without a bundi raita. Indian food here definitely needs a special mention. The sabzis are so good. The paneer khurchan was amazing. The lesuni palak was so good. Even the methi sabzi. You don't expect a methi sabzi to be like really delicious, but this one really is. And these sabzis with their fresh garlic naan, mind-blowing. Coming to the best part of any brunch or buffet, the dessert section. So come, let me take you around. Definitely, I'm going to be taking a little bit of the New York cheesecake. Some mixed fruit pastry. I think I'm going to take a strawberry cupcake and also a chocolate one. Maybe one of this. It seems like a chocolate mousse kind of thingy. Of course, this black forest truffle. I think I'm going to take some of that chocolate and date cake. That's my full plate. That's my full dessert plate. So I'm starting first with the black forest truffle. When at a brunch or buffet, you just can't miss the dessert section. It is heavenly. Thank you. Now, Sunday brunches can be really expensive and luxurious. So my recommendation is that you head to a Sunday brunch if you want to celebrate a special occasion. With that being said, the Hilton is really beautifully done and it does give you that really nice, fancy 5-star feel. So that was it for my brunch experience at the Hilton Mumbai. I absolutely enjoyed the experience. I think their food was delicious. Another thing that I felt in this brunch is that their food was really fresh. A lot of times that is not the feeling that comes when you're eating at a buffet or a brunch, but here the food felt really, really fresh. The price of this Sunday brunch is ₹1,750 plus tax, and if you decide to take the one with alcoholic beverages, then I think it's about ₹2,200 plus taxes. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then don't forget to give it a thumbs up and share this video with your friends with whom you'd like to go for this brunch, and I will see you in my next video. Bye. So as I was filming a video is tough. It's either somebody's hair or somebody's head which will keep popping, and you'll never be able to film one shot in one go.